finale, Rae Jepsen.
She's okay.
Lots of people are really, really lucky. We had your biggest fan on the desk only a couple of segments ago.
We just met backstage.
Oh, wow. How did it go? Sam Fisher.
Oh, he's so sweet. So sweet. So talented. And also, he lives in LA. So, you know, maybe we'll be friends when we're back.
Oh, no.
Is there his soul is going to leave his body again.
Is there a collab in the works, maybe?
And it all started here.
You've been touring Oz for a little bit. And your final shows are here in Melbourne. How's it all going?
I'm having the time of my life. I'm here with my boyfriend, so we're getting a little bit of tourism in and also getting to play some shows. It's really fun.
You did the Harbour Bridge.
We did.
Nervous or just spectacular?
Second time.
Yes. I've never done it. I've always wanted to go. Was it amazing?
It's actually, we are in glamorous. Our janitor outfit. Very glamorous.
I think I saw someone wearing that at the Oscars this morning, actually.
You know, I'm here to give style advice. No, it was really fun. Are you frightened of heights?
No, we've done it.
I haven't done it.
Well, I wouldn't recommend if you're scared to look down. My drummer tried it the first time and he almost peed his pants, so we will be.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, but the rest of us had a great time.
There's nowhere to go when you're on top and you're
No, you're locked in. You've, like, committed to the journey.
Yeah. Yeah. No, I don't think he peed his pants because he needed to go. I don't think
See, I'm thinking like a mum here, you know? Everyone needs to be toileted.
Call Me Maybe, right? It's an iconic song. And you wouldn't have seen, but, like, I've been in nightclubs and pubs. When it comes on, people lose their minds and go absolutely crazy. When you play it live, does it feel like you have a superpower?
Oh, I've never been asked that. I've been asked a lot of questions about Call Me Maybe, but never do I have a superpower. Let's go with sure.
Yeah, easy.
It is a really magical moment. It does feel like kind of nostalgic and special, and the whole crowd ends up singing, so I don't have to do very much work. I get to kind of go like this the whole time. Yeah. It's really fun.
Would you be able to write it now? Because it would be like, not Call Me Maybe, but Text Me Never Maybe.
I know, I thought about exactly. Text me. It wouldn't have the same ring, I don't
think. Right, exactly.
You know?
Nothing. My phone hasn't rung for, I don't know, a decade. Hey, Glastonbury. You're heading to Glastonbury. That's exciting. Is it the first time?
It is. I'm so excited. It's such an iconic festival. So it's been on my bucket list for a while. And I hear Cat Stevens is playing. So I have goals to go to my stage and then run to his stage. There's a couple of people
Tea
I want
for the
to see.
Chiller Man. The album I had from Cat Stevens.
Yeah, very excited.
Yeah, what a legend he is. There's a quote from you that I'm really interested in. You said you aim to break the mold of a pop song.
Oh, in terms of how I look at writing pop, you mean?
Well, what's the mold and how are you breaking it?
I don't know. I think not so much to break a mold, but look at what it is that I love so much about pop music and kind of try to find my own voice in that. I think Call Me Maybe was essentially like the first pop song I'd ever written. I was really into like folk music before that. And then I started to really consider after that song and the height of that song, like what is it that I love so much about pop music? And that led me straight to the 80s, which is how we got my album Emotion. I've been kind of off to the races after that.
Well, I'm really glad you... because we want to talk about this new album, The Loneliest Time, which seems very different, much more introspective sort of a thing. What's driven that?
Oh, you know, we were all locked in our houses for a while. I don't know. I think after Emotion and Dedicated, kind of getting to play a little bit more outside of the 80s, like Dedicated was kind of exploring a bit of 70s and 90s as well. I think with The Loneliest Time, I wasn't looking so much at just like visiting an era, but like a real theme. And the theme of loneliness and the kind of extreme reactions that can cause in us crazy humans was really exciting to me. So I have like playful songs like what it is to join a dating app when you're very lonely, and also like more serious sort of songs about what it is to lose someone you really care about. But I wanted to kind of go there in both extreme ways.
Gee, COVID was awful, wasn't it?
Pricey's just realising now.
I like that you finally got to that conclusion, Pricey. That's great. Head to our website to catch the last of Carly's Aussie shows on her So Nice tour. In the meantime, would you please thank Carly Rae Jepsen?